He calls them all liars, but more and more former Ohio State University wrestlers are coming forward to say their former assistant coach, Congressman Jim Jordan, knew student athletes were being sexually abused and are dumbfounded to understand how Jordan can deny it.
That's a lie. He's lying.
Period.
Period. He's a liar.
Tito Vasquez is the latest, a walk-on wrestler in 1989 who took an elbow to the nose. Sent to team doctor Richard Strauss to stop a nosebleed, the doctor fondled his genitals.
There were some wrestlers with Jordan over to my left-hand side, and I said something to the effect that Doc's hands are freezing and that he examined me thoroughly, extremely thoroughly, my private parts. And everybody was just like, kind of snickering. Jordan said, I have nothing to do with this.
But Jordan heard what you said.
Oh, he heard what I said.
Vasquez, a public school teacher for the past 27 years, is the sixth former Ohio State wrestler to tell CNN they directly told Jim Jordan of the abuse, or Jim Jordan was present when someone was recalling abuse by the team's doctor. Eight more former wrestlers tell CNN the abuse by Dr. Richard Strauss was such a routine topic of conversation that it's inconceivable Jordan did not know. Yet Jordan, now a powerful Republican congressman, refuses to budge.
You've got six former Ohio State wrestlers who absolutely say you knew about Dr. Strauss because they either told you at the time or you were there
heard it. You guys are still asking about this after the Perkins Coie, Clinton's law firm investigated this and didn't even mention my name once.
Well, they didn't mention your name, but they mentioned that 20 coaches knew about it.
Every single coach has said the same thing I have. All kinds of athletes have said the same thing I have. And the reason they've all said that is because it's the truth. Look, if I'd have known there was some kind of problem, some kind of abuse, I'd have helped out our athletes. What they're saying is just not true.
Richard Strauss killed himself in 2005. Last year, an independent investigation concluded while Dr. Strauss worked at OSU over two decades, he sexually abused at least 177 male student patients. Jim Jordan called the report a vindication because it did not name him. The report did not name any wrestling coach at Ohio State, did not find documentary evidence coaches were aware of complaints against Strauss, but 22 coaches confirmed to the investigative team that they were aware of rumors and or complaints about Strauss. Former OSU wrestler Dunyasha Yetz says Jordan is one of the coaches who knew because he told him. In January of 1993, Yetz went to see Strauss for a thumb sprain, and the doctor tried to pull down his pants. Yetz says he kicked open the doctor's door to escape. Jordan was right outside next to an ice machine.
He jumped up like, what's going on? I said, Coach, he just tried to give me a physical exam for my thumb injury. Look, it looked like a baseball. It swelled up. And he was like, man, if he ever tried that, I would kill him.
Jordan supporters say Yetz can't be trusted because of a past conviction for fraud. But two other wrestlers told CNN they witnessed the encounter.
What Dr. Strauss took from me that day was my dignity.
Last year, former wrestlers Dan Ritchie and Mike Flusci told the Ohio legislature that among athletes and coaches, Strauss's sexual abuse was an open discussion.
I do recall somebody bringing up something to one of the assistant coaches, and his response was simply, well, if you ever tried that with me, I'd snap his neck like a stick of dry balsa wood.
And I remember the exact phrase about, if that happened to me, I'd break his neck.
The coach who talked about breaking Strauss's neck was Jim Jordan, according to both Ritchie and Flusci, who didn't name him in front of the legislature, but have since confirmed it to CNN.
And what they're saying now is just not accurate.
Mike Flusci, Dan Ritchie, you don't remember telling them you'd break the guy's neck if he did that to you?
Despite the specific allegations, Jordan's office says his statement stands. He knew nothing of the abuse. Drew Griffin, CNN, Washington.